Today, we are going to be talking about the pros and cons of Zapier. In case you don't know me, I'm Mariah and my business is Bloom Hustle Grow, where I help service-based entrepreneurs make the hustle happier by organizing and optimizing their business operations. Zapier is a third-party tool that you can use to automate processes and to make your tools talk together potentially. There's a lot of things that you can do with Zapier, but there are pros and cons to using that kind of service. So I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about that today. Zapier can do some pretty amazing things, and I do love getting to play around with it and seeing like all the possibilities. It's so cool. I just feel like it's like a little bit of magic that you can create, but just because you can do it doesn't mean you should. So my biggest caution around using Zapier is it should not be holding together all of your business operations. Your core business tools that you're using in your business operations, they really should be talking directly to each other. You should not be relying on Zapier to onboard your clients. For example, when you onboard somebody who buys a course from you, Zapier shouldn't be talking between your payment processor and your email service and your course platform. Each one of those things should integrate directly. It should not be having to go through Zapier between those three core tools. You can watch the tech stack video to get a better idea of what I'm talking about. It's like having duct tape holding together your car engine, essentially. But that doesn't mean Zapier is all bad. I'm not against Zapier. I just feel really strongly that direct integration is best for your core business operations, for those things that people are paying for and are going to get upset if they don't get their like onboarding emails and stuff. So let's dive into a little bit about what Zapier is actually good for. It could totally be used for any short-term project that you might be doing. A good example of this is maybe like you're hosting a summit and you're hosting it on a different platform that you don't use on a regular basis, and maybe you need a workaround for that. So if Zapier is your workaround, cool. I would say that's okay. If it's like a one-time thing where you're using some tool that you're not going to really use again. The second way that I really love Zapier, kind of on more long-term, is keeping your team updated. It's a great way to share information that your team might need. Maybe it is from your payment processor. So for example, if you have a Facebook group that you're running for a paid program, there's no way to really just like automatically add people to a Facebook group, and one of your team members needs to approve that person. So in this instance, it would be a great way to use Zapier to notify that team member, hey, this person bought the course, so you can let them in. Depending on what tools you're using, has that capability to do that. I personally had used it where we had it set up with Stripe, and Stripe would talk to Zapier, and then it would shoot into Slack. So then our team knew, hey, we have a new member to this course that needs to be onboarded into the Facebook group. Zapier can also be a great way to set automatic reminders for different other programs. So you can have a reminder go to Trello, or you can have a reminder go to Slack. If you have like, we need this data at a certain point in time, if you want to automate that, those kinds of reminders, it's a great way to do that. I also use Zapier with Buffer and Trello to create an evergreen social media library. So Zapier allows me to automatically take posts that I've created within Trello and move that over to my Buffer scheduling tool, which I use for Facebook, but you can also use it for Twitter and you can use it for LinkedIn. It's really cool to be able to have those three tools talk to each other and have a way where I have that evergreen social media library. Three examples are great ways to use Zapier. There's so many possibilities with Zapier, but just as a reminder, please, please don't be using it as the primary integration between your email marketing system, your payment processor, and your client delivery system, whether that's a course platform or CRM. It's just not the way to go long-term for your tool. I just would not recommend relying on that third party kind of duct tape to have those three core systems talk to each other. If you are just getting started with your business, you can grab my business tools resource list below, and it gives you a shortcut to choosing any of your business tools.